Very good morning, children. Today I'm here with my new topic of the same chapter 2 in science, prevention of communicable diseases. So in our previous videos we have learned the different topics like food, the different kinds of food groups, the component of the food, different nutrients, their sources, the relationship between the food and health, diseases, kinds of diseases, communicable and non-communicable diseases, the communicable spread of the communicable diseases. So today the topic is prevention of communicable diseases. So children, how we prevent the diseases, how we can self prevent the diseases for spreading. So prevention is what is the meaning of prevention here? The action of stopping something from happening means if you want to stop something, then we definitely have to do some work, something against their, we have to perform some action against their spread. So this is the action of stopping something from happening. So this is the prevention. So communicable diseases can be prevented by good hygiene and vaccination. So prevention is better than cure, as we all know. This is a very famous phrase or proverb. So prevention is always better than cure. So nowadays we are taking a prevention. We are taking a prevention that we are staying at our home. We are fighting against corona. So this is also the thing by which we can stop. We want to stop the spreading of corona disease. So this is the prevention we are taking today, nowadays. So hygiene. What is the meaning of hygiene? These are some words which are new for you. So hygiene, it is the practice, or it is a condition and practice that help to maintain good health, and prevent the spread of diseases. So we can say that hygiene is the practice that ensure our cleanliness. Hygiene is directly related to our self-cleanliness and good health, especially the personal hygiene. Hygiene belongs to the personal cleanliness, like if you are wearing clean clothes, if you are taking bath regularly, if you are doing work after washing your hands properly. So these are something which is said to be as hygiene or personal hygiene. So which personal hygiene, which refers to maintaining the individual's body cleanliness, particular person, how a boy, how a girl is trying to keep their body clean, taking bath regularly, by cutting their nails, by washing their hands before and after eating, by trimming their hairs. These are some smaller personal cleanliness and some personal hygiene. So there are some steps of good hygiene which we will discuss here. The first step is wash our hands before and after eating food and when we go to the washroom. So we must have to wash our hand with the soap. So when we eat with the dirty hands, or when we have our lunch, when we have our breakfast, when we have our dinner, without washing our hands, definitely the microorganisms which are unseen, which are very small microorganisms, they mix with the food item and they go inside our mouth. So by this they infect our body, or they infect our internal organs. So it is very essential to wash our hand with the soap before and after eating. The next point is, do not allow water to stand in pots, coolers, ditches, etc. You in your surrounding, in the near your houses, we can see easily there are so many pits, there are so many ditches where the rain water or the dirty water actually stand. So when the water collected or accumulate, collected in the ponds, pots or in the ditches or in the coolers, then the small insect and the mosquitoes, especially the mosquitoes, easily develop in the stagnant water, ruka hua pani. Stagnant is ruka hua pani. They easily develop their larva in the stagnant water. So we must have to drain these stagnant water. That is why we can prevent ourselves from the mosquito, and we can prevent ourselves or our surrounding by the against the spread of malaria disease. Now the next is the use of mosquito net and mosquito repellent. As you all are using in your home mosquito repellent, like the Good Night and all kind of things, you all know. Wash fruits and vegetables carefully before cooking and before eating. It is very mandatory. Food must be kept covered. Yes, of course. This is also the very important, to keep our food items or all the eatable things covered, so that flies cannot be sit on the food item and food eatable things, and we can keep ourselves safe by the different various kind of diseases, because flies are the carriers of the germs. They spread the germs rapidly from the various areas. Then drink clean water and pure water. By we can keep our water pure by boiling process, by filtering process, and by the chlorinating. Chlorine is the chemical which is usually mixed with the water to clean or purify the water. So we can make it germ free, and by doing this we can make our water germ free. Now the dustbin, use of dustbin. It is very important to use a dustbin, because dustbins, there are two types of dustbins. You all know our Nagar Nigam is providing blue and green dustbins, in which we can keep the garbage, the undesirable material inside it. The use of dustbin is also very essential for self-cleanliness and the hygiene, for good hygiene. So these are all the points. Now the next point of this same chapter is vaccination or vaccine. So basically, vaccine, the way by which we can prevent ourselves from communicable diseases are vaccination. So vaccination is what? It is the way by which we can prevent. By which we can prevent. Prevent means bachana. Ek tarika jisse hum bacha sakte hain. A process by which we can prevent ourselves from various communicable diseases. Communicable diseases, you know, you remember the disease which easily spread from one person to another? Yes. So vaccination is the way. This is the ek tarika. So vaccines of different kinds of vaccines are available nowadays, like polio vaccines, cholera vaccines, tetanus vaccine, hepatitis vaccines, these all. So the way by which we can prevent ourselves from the communicable diseases are vaccination. These vaccination help our body to gain the immunity. These vaccination, what the vaccination do? Actually, what are the function of the vaccine, or how the vaccine work? So basically, they develop the immunity. They develop the immunity against the disease, particular disease. So we can easily fight, our body easily fight with the disease. Like corona disease, the disease, in this disease the vaccines are yet not formed, and scientists are still struggling for making the vaccine. If we create a vaccine of this corona COVID-19, then we can easily win this battle. Okay, so this is all for today, beta. Now there is a thing which is very important, and this is the homework or task which you have to learn it. Things to remember: the disease caused by deficiency of vitamin B1 is beriberi. Exercise improves our blood circulation and tones up our muscles. The roughage is the undigested part of plant food. Typhoid, cholera are the disease caused by bacteria. Female anopheles mosquito is the insect which spread malaria. So these are the important points which you have to learn and remember. This is the homework. This is today's homework. So learn it carefully, children. Thank you.